Welcome to Google Developers Tutorial Video. In this tutorial video, we will be creating a custom JavaScript visualization in Data Studio. The overview learning of this tutorial are 1. How a Google Data Studio community visualization works. 2. How to build a community visualization using the DS Component Helper library. 3. How to integrate your community visualization into a Data Studio dashboard. Firstly, what is Google Data Studio? It lets users build live, interactive dashboards with beautiful data visualizations, for free. Users can fetch their data from a variety of sources and create reports in Data Studio, with full editing and sharing capabilities. Data Studio provides several built-in chart types, including line charts, bar chart, pie charts, and scatter plots. Community visualizations allow you to build and use your own custom JavaScript visualizations in Data Studio. You can also share your community visualizations with others so that they can use them with their own data. The image shown below is an example report in Data Studio. Next, we will be creating a community visualization. We need the following files in a Google Cloud Platform storage bucket. That are, manifest.json, myviz.json, myviz.js and myviz.css. Note that, the manifest is the only file that has a required name, but the other files can be named differently, as long as their name or location is specified in your manifest file. Then next, we will be creating the JavaScript files required for creating a community visualization. Step 1. Download the dscc.min.js file from the Data Studio Community Component Library and copy it to your working directory. Step 2. Copy the following code into a text editor and save it as myvizsource.js in your local working directory. Step 3. Combine all JavaScript required into a single file by copying the contents of the Visualization Helper library and your myvizsource.js file into a new file named myviz.js, or run the following commands to concatenate the files. Then next, copy the following code and save it as myviz.css. The CSS file defines the styling for your visualization. Then, copy the following code and save it as myviz.json. Next, we will be creating a cloud storage project and bucket. Step 1. Create a Google Cloud Platform project. But I have already created the GCP project, so I will be going to next step. Step 2. Create a GCP bucket. Step 3. Take note of your bucket name and path, beginning with the section after buckets. Data Studio calls that component ID, and it will be used for identification and deployment. In the next step, copy the following code into a text editor and save it as manifest.json. The manifest file provides information about your visualization location and resources. But inside the resource components in the manifest.json, we have to give the bucket path for the files. Then upload the files to your desired path in your bucket. Next, we will be testing our community visualization in Data Studio. Step 1. Create a blank under New Report of Data Studio. Step 2. Select the Google Sheets connector. Step 3. I will be using the direct method through using Google Drive, where I have downloaded data set. Step 4. In the toolbar, click the Community Visualization button. This opens a drop-down. Step 5. In the drop-down, click Explore More to open the Community Gallery shade. Step 6. Click Build Your Own Visualization. Step 7. Paste your bucket name prefixed into the text input for Manifest Path, and click Submit. This should render one visualization card. Step 8. Click the visualization icon to add it to your report. Then next, we will use the color selector style element to update your visualization. Replace the code in your myvizsource.js file with the code below. Then create the combined JavaScript file, then re-upload your visualization files to Google Cloud Storage. Refresh the Data Studio report where you tested your community visualization. Then next, we will render the data as a bar chart. Replace the code in your myvizsource.js file with the code below. Then create the combined JavaScript file, then re-upload your visualization files to Google Cloud Storage. Refresh the Data Studio report where you tested your community visualization. You should have a bar chart with labels generated from the data in the Google Sheet. Final step is dynamically add a title and apply a CSS style. Replace the code in your myvizsource.js file with the code below. Then create the combined JavaScript file, then re-upload your visualization files to Google Cloud Storage. Refresh the Data Studio report where you tested your community visualization. You should have a bar chart with a title generated from the data and styled using your myviz.css file. Congratulations, you've created a community visualization in Data Studio. Thank you for watching this video, but don't forget to subscribe to our channel.